Hello everyone, myself Professor Pritish Chitte, working in mechanical engineering department in Walchand stop technology. In our first session we will start with introduction to lathe machine. There are the different types of machines like lathe machine, shaping machine, drilling machine, milling machine, planing machine. These are the parts of manufacturing technology courses. Now these are the learning outcomes. The students will be able to explain the working principle of the lathe machine. Also they can describe the different components or the parts of the lathe machine. What we will learn in this session? First we will learn with working principle. After that, what are the specifications of the lathe machine and the parts or the components of the lathe machine. Working principle. As you can see in the diagram, the lathe machine is a machine tool which consists of the workpiece. Mainly the cylindrical type of workpiece can be used in the lathe machine. And these workpieces can be held in the job holding devices. There may be the different job holding devices like the centers, the live center and dead center. Also, we can use the types of chucks, face plate, angle plate, driving plate, lathe carrier, mandrels. These components can be called as job holding devices. Now the second part is that the workpiece or the job is rotating while the cutting tool is supported by the tool holding devices. The tool holding devices can be called as tool post. In lathe machine, in most of the lathe machine, square tool post is used, means the four tools can be used at a time for the cutting operation. Mainly lathe machine is used for the removal of material. Material means mainly the metal. So this is called as metal removal process. And there are the two cases whenever we want to cut the material, whenever we want to remove the material. In this diagram you can see the tool is moving parallel to the axis of rotation. Here the job is rotating and the tool is moving parallel to the axis of rotation. Means we can get the cylindrical type of surfaces. Now in the second diagram the workpiece is rotating and the tool is moving perpendicular to the axis of rotation. Perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the workpiece. Now, in this case, we can get the flat type of surfaces. So, this is the working principle of the lathe machine. Mainly, the lathe machine consists of the workpiece with the job holding devices and the cutting tool with the tool holding devices. Now you can see there is a schematic diagram of the lathe machine. Now you can see here the workpiece is rotating. This is a spindle, this is the headstock, this is a tailstock. Always the headstock will be to the left hand side, which is fixed. The tailstock always it is moving in the guideways which are provided in the bed. This is the tool post, which is a part of a carriage. Carriage is the main part where the tool post is kept here. This is a workpiece and the types of chuck or maybe the face plate can be used for the work holding devices. Now, let's specification. Specification means dimensions, parameters. Now, in some countries like the United States of America, The lathe is specified by the swing, means that will be the maximum diameter that can be accommodated by the machine. The type of lathe which is called as sliding, surfacing and the screw cutting. And in the England, the lathe machine is specified by the height of the center, which is the half of the swing over the bed. Now, what are the main specification or the dimensions of the lathe machine? The first one, this is the maximum distance between the center. This is the one center which is called as live center, which is at the headstock. This is the dead center, which is at the tailstock. After that, B dimension, this one is, we always called as the swing, maximum swing in the gap. The C is the height of the center from the bed. D is the maximum swing over the carriage, this is the carriage. And E is the swing over the bed. This is the bed and this is the swing over the bed in the diameter in mm. Now this is one example of the lathe specification of the Harrier lathe machine manufactured by the Kirloskar. You can see the diagram. So maximum distance between the centers, that is 600 mm. Maximum swing over the bed, that is 330 mm. Height of the center is 165 mm. Maximum swing over the carriage is 210 mm. These four are the main specification of the lathe machine. These are also the specification, but these are the four main specification of the lathe machine. After that, we can call that the width of the bed, after the hole through the spindle where we can fix the job, the faceplate diameter. Faceplate is also a one type of job holding devices with 300 mm. Just go through the question. Which is the most important dimension in lathe machine? Just think about this question. Now, after that question, we will move towards the parts of the lathe machine. What are the different, the main parts of the lathe machine, or we can also call that the main components of the lathe machine? Now you can see this diagram very properly. So this is the bed, which is the base of the lathe machine. This should be a sturdy with high strength, which is manufactured by the cast iron mainly. Headstock is an assembly which consists of the different components we will discuss in detail. After that, the spindle, which is present inside the headstock. Tailstock, this is the tailstock which is at the right hand side. The live center may be present here. The dead center is present here. Also, suppose I want to perform a drilling operation. So where I can fix the drill tool? Yes, you can remove this dead center from the tailstock and you can fix the drill tool inside the tailstock, and you can move this tailstock nearer to the workpiece, and that can be sliding inside the bed weights. But the headstock, which is sturdy, which is fixed to the bed. Carriage is one of the most important part of the lathe machine. Now, what it consists of? You can see the handwheel is provided. The lathe machine is the conventional machine. Each and every operation you have to perform manually. For example, suppose you want to place the job inside the job holding devices. Yes, manually we have to do. Suppose you want to change the tool from the tool holding devices or the tool post. Yes, you have to do manually. Suppose you want to slide this tailstock in the bed ways. Yes, you have to take this tailstock here. If suppose you want to move this carriage, yes, with the help of hand wheel you have to do. After that feedback mechanism, there are the different types of mechanisms we are learning in the parts of lathe machine. Now, the bed weights. You can see the two diagrams here. The, as we have discussed, the bed edge is a base of the lathe machine. You can see here the V bed ways are there where we can slide maybe a carriage or maybe the tailstock. If suppose we are having the flat surfaces, means there may be a chances of going the chips inside that. But here we are having the V bedways, means there are no chances of going the chips inside that. And it should be a study, because whenever you are having the vibrational cases, whenever you are having the cutting operation, it should be a study position. And it's a made of piece. These are the references.